When working with systems of equations, there's a few special cases for substitution that you need to be aware of. If the variables subtract out to zero, then it means either there is infinite solutions, or no solution. In example 1, I'm going to solve for x, and then substitute that piece in for x in the second equation. I'll do this by subtracting 4y from both sides. When I do this, I get 4y - -7. Taking this value and plugging it in for x in the second equation gives me 21 + 3 times the value -4y - 7 = -12y. Now everything's in terms of y. When we solve this, we get 21 + -12y - -21 = -12y. From here, if we combine like terms, we see that 21 adds to 0, and we have -12y = -12y. We see at this point that it's an identity, but we can keep going by adding 12y to both sides, and that gives us 0 = 0. Yes, there are infinite solutions because the variables subtract out to 0. You can see that in this particular example, example 1, it's extremely important to solve your equation properly, or you will come to the wrong solution and solve it improperly. But if you realize that whatever's on one side is identical to the other side, and it adds or subtracts out to 0 = 0, you have infinite solutions. In example 2, I'm going to isolate y by subtracting 5x from both sides. This gives me y = -5x + 3. Taking this value and substituting it in for y in the second equation gives me 8 - 3 - -5x + 3 = 15x. Distributing my -3, I get 8 + 15x - 9 = 15x. If I subtract 15x from both sides, I get 8 - 9 = 0. At this point, I can add like terms together, which would give me -1 = 0. Notice that this is not true. Because -1 does not equal 0. So, we can say that there are no solutions.